He rapped out his orders. He delivered his orders to the driver. Set Aldert's police station means just drive to police station and step on it. Means he was over there and he said, just go up, step on it and take Jackson. And he said, this van is there, take Jackson and Stephens here, and when you get there, ask the bell, ask for Bell, Chief Inspector Bell. Got that? You go up and take these two persons over there and make a call to Chief Inspector. Okay. And this Bell is the Chief Inspector. In the beginning, we have just learned about one of the characters, right? He leaped the stairs to his office three at a time, got Bell on the phone immediately. He made a call to Bell and put the facts before him. He told everything to him. We will get him, sir, said Bell from the another side on phone. We will get him with a bit of luck. The governor sat back and lit a cigarette. Yeah, God, what a beautifully led plan it had all been. What a clever fellow Evans was, careless leaving that question paper. Means intentionally, deliberately he had kept that question paper back. And but then they all made their mistakes somewhere along the line. Well, almost all of them, and that's why very, very shortly Mr. Clever Evans would be back inside doing his once more. Means I am hopeful that very soon Evans would be back in the cell. The phone on his desk erupted in a strident burst. So the sound of the phone was not pleasing, so strident burst, and Superintendent Carter informed him that, means governor informed the governor that McCleary had spotted Evans driving off along L Street. He had spotted. They had got the number of the car all right and had given chase immediately, but unfortunately had lost him. All of a sudden he disappeared somewhere. We could not trace him after that at the Headington roundabout, and he must have doubled back into the city. Means they were moving round and round, and maybe he was ditching them round and round, and this in this way doubled back into the city. No, said the governor quietly. No, he is on his way to Newbury. Go to Newbury, he must be on his way. He explained his reasons for believing so and left it at that. It was a police job now. Why should I care for, why should I get puzzled, why should I bother about everything? This is the matter of the police, and let the police look into the matter in their own way. Notice, he was just another good for a giggle. He was just about to giggle or mildly laugh. Gullible governor, he was just a guilty governor, gullible, who makes mistake, that a confused governor, and that was all. By the way, Carter, I hope you managed to get McCleary to the hospital, all right? Have you taken McCleary to hospital? Yes, sir. He is in the Red Cliff. He is in the Red Cliff now, really groggy, means very bloody and weak, right? So he was when we got to the examination offices, and they rang for the ambulance from there. When we went over there, they accepted that they rang for the ambulance. The governor rang the Red Cliff, means hospital, a few minutes later and asked for the accident department. He just wanted to confirm whether McCleary was in the hospital or not. McCleary, you say? Yes, he is a person. Means on phone. What are you saying? McCleary? Yes, he is a person. No. I don't think there is anyone. No, we don't have any person, any patient with this name. Yeah, there is. You will find one of your ambulances picked him up from Elsfield way about. Means one of the ambulances came to us and they said that they had come from the hospital, and we just handed over McCleary to them, and they said that they were taking McCleary to the hospital. That's why you yourself sent the ambulance. Oh, that, yes, we sent an ambulance, all right, but when we got there, the fellow had gone. Yeah, we did send the ambulance, but our people, when went there, they found no one. No one seemed to know where he was, and since then nobody knows where McCleary is. Just vanished, disappeared, not even a single sign, no clue was there, but the governor was no longer listening, and the truth seemed to hit him with an almost physical impact somewhere in the back of his neck. Right? A quarter of an hour later, they found the Reverend S. McCleary securely bound and gagged. About a quarter of an hour later means after 15 minutes, they found the real Reverend S. McCleary securely bound and gagged in his study in Broad Street. Have you got the clue? Means what? Who sir was McCleary earlier? He was just fake. He was not real McCleary. He is real McCleary, but in the very beginning when the plot was to start, he was found and he was bound and put in a room over there. Means since 8:15 a.m. he had been there when two men had called, and in this way he was telling that I was kept detained here only. He was real McCleary. Inquiries in Newbury throughout the afternoon produced nothing. No result was there. Inquiries were going on, nothing at all. And by tea time, everyone in the prison knew what had happened. It had not been Evans impersonating McCleary who had walked out. Look here. Now everybody had come to know that it had not been Evans impersonating McCleary who had walked out. Actually, it was not Evans who was bearing the look, who was bearing the name of McCleary who had walked out. Evans did not walk out. Yes, they were thinking that Evans had run away, but Evans did not run away in the name of McCleary. It had been Evans impersonating McCleary, but it was Evans who really had been in the cell taking the resemblance of McCleary. In the name of McCleary, he remained inside the cell. Evans actually remained in the cell and he had taken up the resemblance of McCleary, and everybody thought that McCleary was inside the cell and Evans had run away. But the thing is that McCleary had already run away, and in the impersonation of McCleary, Evans was in the cell. Is that clear now, students? This is the main confusion generally students are confused about. Right. The fish and chips were delicious, and after a gentle stroll round the center of Chipping, Norton Evans decided to return to the hotel and have an early night. Actually, Evans was enjoying an evening walk, and after having some refreshment, he just decided to get back to his hotel Golden Lion, you know. So he decided and he just planned to have an early night. Early night means he just wanted to go to bed before time. He wanted to get relaxed. A smart new hat concealed the wreckage of his closely cropped hair, and he kept it on as he walked up to the reception desk of the Golden Lion. This is the name of the hotel. And he went to the reception. It would take a good while for his hair to regain its former glory. So he thought that I would once again and get back my lost hair. But what the hell did that matter? What difference does it make? He was out again, wasn't he? A bit means he was out again means he had run away from the jail once again, didn't he? A bit of bad luck that when Jackson had pinched his scissors, because it had meant a long and tricky operation with his only razor blade the previous night. Actually, it was very, he was thinking that I was just shocked in the beginning when that prison officer had taken away his scissors. So he was thinking that was one of the important tools, but it's okay. But he had his good luck too. Just think, if Jackson had made him take his bobble hat off, phew, that really had been a close call. Means he would have been caught. Means he, you know, students, in the very beginning he was told to remove his hat, that cap was there, right? So he was saying thank God, in the form of my lucky charm I was wearing that bobble hat. Thank God he did not remove it, otherwise my game in the very beginning, before my game started, it would have been come to an end. It would have been ended. Still, old Jackson wasn't such a bad fellow. Thank God, Jackson was not so bad. One of the worst things, what? Funny, really, had been the beard. My beard was very funny, and that really helped me. He had always been allergic to sticking plaster. Actually, he did not want to use that false beard because he had allergy. He had been allergic to these sticky things, right? And even now his chin was irritating, sore and red. And when he used that sticky beard on his face, so he had got this eruption, skin eruption was there, and you know, sore and red were there on his chin. His chin was red. The receptionist wasn't the same girl who had booked him in. Means when Evans came to the hotel, different receptionist was there, but now the receptionist was different. But the charging was but the change was definitely for the better. But whatever the change was there, that was good. As means the change means different receptionist was much better than the previous one. She was maybe she was more beautiful or attractive. As he collected his key, he gave her his best smile, means flattering. Told her he would not be bothering with breakfast. So please do not think of my breakfast. I won't take breakfast. So please don't disturb me, right? And ordered the Daily Express newspaper and asked for an early morning call at 6:45 a.m. And he placed his instructions with the reception that I just do not want breakfast. Number one, this is one of the questions. What instructions were given to the receptionist by Evans? He did not want breakfast. Number two, he wanted this newspaper, Daily Express. And number three, he was supposed to be awakened at 6:45 a.m. Tomorrow was going to be another busy day. He had something different in his mind. He whistled softly to himself as he walked up the broad stairs. He had sort of liked the idea of being dressed up as a minister, dog collar and everything. You know, this dog collar was there, right, in this way. And fake McLeary had brought two dog collars for him. So yes, it had been a jolly good idea for McLeary to wear two black fronts, two collars. They are known as dog collars, right? Clerical collars, we may call. So, but that top collar, phew, it had kept on slipping off the black stud, and there had been that one panicky moment when McLeary had only just got his hand up to his neck in time to stop the collars springing apart before Stephen. Means one moment, one very unfortunate, crucial moment was there when Stephen was there, and in front of him, two back collars were there, and one of them was about to drop. But thank God, this so-called McLeary, fake McLeary, had already come to know of that, and he had already held that in this way. Right? Thank God, Stephen couldn't come to know. Ah, they had got that little problem worked out all right. They solved our problem. Though a pan stuck in the mouth whenever the evil eye had appeared at the peephole. Easy. Thank God we took up this position. That's why they got bored, that every time they had a peep look, they found the same position. That's why they did not bother about that. Right? That had been far more difficult than they had ever bargained for. Everything else had gone beautifully, smoothly, though thank God everything was okay in the car. He had found everything they had promised him. Everything, whatever he wanted, he found everything in the car. Soap, water, cloths, the map, everything was helpful to him. Yes, the map, of course. The ordinance. You know, students? The map was there, Google map like, right? Of course, the ordnance survey map of Oxfordshire, and he had got some good friends, some very clever friends. Oh God, ah, right. So he unlocked his bedroom door. Now Evans was about to enter his room door in the hotel, and closed it quietly from behind, and then stood frozen to the spot. But he was wonderstruck. What happened? Means he found someone or some people, right, frozen to the spot like a man who has just caught a glimpse of the Gorgon. something very horrible he might have seen. So, sitting on the narrow bed was the very last man in the world that Evans had expected. Yes, Evans had never expected this person or wanted to see. It was not worth trying anything. Now, Evans got just get ready to go back to the cell. Now, it's of no use making any efforts. You have been over smart, said the governor quietly, as Evans' eyes darted desperately, in a nervous way around the room. I have got men all around the place. Yes, you cannot run away. Well, there were only two, really, but Evans need not know that. He let the words sink in. Women too? Means you have arranged women also? Didn't you think the blonde girl, means brown golden hair girl, in reception was rather sweet? Are you talking about that? She was really sweet. Evans was visibly shaken. He didn't know. So, he didn't believe. He sat down slowly in the only chair the small room could offer, and in this way he held his head between his hands. For several minutes there was utter silence. You can see in this way, this is governor and this is Evans. Finally, he spoke. It was that bloody correction slip, I suppose. I think you have got just because of this bloody that correction slip. Well, the governor failed to mask the deep satisfaction in his voice. There are a few people who know a little German. Very few people know this German language. Slowly, very slowly, Evans relaxed. He was beaten and he knew it. He sat up at last and managed to smile ruefully, as if he had something in his mind. You know, it wasn't really a mistake. You see, we hadn't been able to fix up any hotel, but we could have worked that some other way. Evans is telling, actually we wanted to go elsewhere, we didn't have any fixed hotel, so we had no other way. No, the really important thing was for the phone to ring just before the exam finished, to get everyone out of the way for a couple of minutes. So, we had to know exactly when the exam started, didn't we? He is just making confession and he is just clearing the fact. And like a fool, I presented you with that little piece of information on a plate. Oh, sir, actually this is the part of my planning and I just wanted to confuse you, and with that correction slip, I did that. Well, somebody did. So, you see, sir, that correction slip killed two little birds with a single stone, didn't it? The name of the hotel for me and the exact time the exam started for you know, means he's saying everything I decided, everything is the part of my planning. The governor nodded. It's a pretty common word. Good job. It's a pretty common, sir. And I would never have known where to come to, would I? I didn't know where I would go and where would I come to know? Oh, nice name, though, some golden law, and you know, this is German language and that hotel's name was there. How did you know which golden law it was? There's hundreds of them, means so many hotels with the same name are there. How could you come to know that I am here only? Evans is asking. Same as you, Mr. Evans, you are not the only smart person. We are also smart. So, same as Evans, index number 313, center number 271, remember these words, 6 figures, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And if you take an ordnance survey map, Google map, like right for Oxfordshire, you find that the 6 figure reference 313/271 lands you bang in the middle of Chipping Norton. That's why we got. Yeah, you are right. Oh, we had hoped you would run off to Newbury. Actually, we hoped that you would go to Newbury. We went there. Well, that's something, I suppose. Something was there. Yeah, that question paper, Evans, could you really understand all the German? I could hardly. Evans, I could hardly come to know what was there, but did you know? Now, of course, I could not know. I knew roughly what it was all about, but we just hoped it would throw a few spanners in the work, means it would really work in some strange way. This is an idiomatic phrase, you know, sort of muddle everybody a bit, means sort of things to confuse others. The governor stood up. Tell me one thing before we go. Yes, Ivan, tell me one more thing. What, how on earth did you get all that blood to pour over your head? Actually, we found you in the cell and you were blood stained, your face was covered with blood. How could you arrange all these things? Ivan suddenly looked a little happier. Clever, sir. Very easy. It was a clever plan. Very clever that was. How to get her? It was very clever. It was very easy to get a couple of pints of blood into a cell. Yeah. When there is none there to start off with, and when the invigilator, shall we say, gets searched before he comes in, we search everything. And yes, sir, you can well ask about that, and I don't know if I ought to tell you. If you ask me from where, I cannot. After all, I might want to use that particular blood, and I did get nothing more than that I can tell you. Anything to do with the little rubber ring for piles, perhaps? Is there anything to do with that rubber ring? You know, in the very beginning we were told that for the piles patient this was useful. Ivan's grinned feebly, very lightly he just smiled and laughed. Clever though, wasn't it? Very good, clever plan, wasn't it? Must have been a tricky job sticking a couple of pins. Nah, you have got it wrong, sir. No problem about that. About that blood, no problem. No means nah. Is the clotting, you see, generally this is the common feature of the blood to get sticky and get clotted. So that's the big trouble. We got the blood easy enough. Getting the blood was not problematic. And we arranged pig's blood. It was from the slaughter's house in Kidlington. But to stop it clotting, you have got to mix your actual blood, right? Only then, with the reaction, that blood will not get clogged, right? He once took a breath. With a 1/10 of its own volume of 3.8% centrizodium citrate. Didn't know that, did you, sir? Just because of that, our blood was in liquid form. The governor shook his head in a token of reluctant, means unwilling admiration. He did not want to admire, but he had to. We learn something new every day, they tell me. Come on, my lad, come on, my chap. Ivan made no show of resistance. He did not oppose, and side by side, the two men walked slowly down the stairs. Now they were leaving the hotel. Tell me, Ivan, how did you manage to plan all this business? You have had no visitors, nobody was allowed to visit you. I have seen to that. You have had no letters, no letter was also there. I got lots of friends though. He is saying nobody, I know nobody came, but still I have lots of friends. What that supposed to mean? Lots of friends means? Actually, my German teacher, for a start, let me start from the beginning. You know, I had a private tuition and a German teacher used to come to teach me, so I began my plan with that. You mean? Yes, but he was from the technical college. How could he help you? Was it from technical college? Ivan was almost enjoying it all now. No, sir, he was also fake. Ever check up on him, sir? Have you ever checked whether he was really from technical college? You got this, sir. God Almighty, there is far more going on than I. Always will be, sir. Everything ready? Asked the governor as they stood by the reception desk. The van is out, means the receptionist was asked whether everything was ready. Then she said, sir, the van is out the front, sir, said the pretty blonde receptionist. Evans winked at her once again as if he had still something in his mind, and she winked back at him in the confirmation that, sir, don't worry, everything is okay. Right? It almost made his day in this way. When she winked back, he liked that day. A silent prison officer handcuffed the recaptured Evans, and together the two men clambered awkwardly into the back seat of the prison van. These two people sat in the prison van. See you soon, Evans. It was almost as if the governor was saying farewell to an old friend after cocktail party. It looked that they were really giving him farewell, right? Cheer up, sir. Best of luck, sir. All the best. I was just wondering, I know your German is pretty good, sir, but do you know any more of these modern languages? Do you know German or any other modern language also? Not very well. Why? But why are you asking? Ivan settled himself comfortably on the back seat and grinned happily. He was happy and he was smiling as if he had something wrong in his mind. Nothing really, I just happened to notice that you have got some O-level Italian classes coming up next September, that's all. I think next time you will have Italian O-level examination. Perhaps you won't be with us next September, Evans. James Roderick Evans appeared to ponder. He was about to think the governor's words deeply. No, perhaps no, I won't. I won't be back, sir, he said, as the prison van turned right from Chipping Norton onto the Oxford Road. The hitherto silent prison officer unlocked the handcuffs. So, you know, he was wearing some handcuffs. So, these two prison persons just unlocked his handcuffs. It means these people were also fake. These prison officers were also fake. Van was fake. Okay, so they unlocked his handcuffs and leaned forward towards the driver. For God's sake, for Christ's sake, means for God's sake, get a move on. Make it fast. It won't take them long to find out. Where do you suggest we make for, sir? Where should we go? Asked the driver in a broad Scots accent. He was asking, sir, where to go? What about Newbury? What do you think? If he head to Newbury, suggested Evans in his funny way as a part of his planning finally. And so, dear students, in this way, this chapter is over, and I hope you might have liked that, you might have got it word by word. So, see you next time with some other topic. Until then, have a nice time. Thank you.